What's up, tennis enthusiast? My name is Jeff Lewis, and I'm at my new home base, the beautiful Chenal Country Club in Little Rock, Arkansas. Today's video is all about tennis volley technique. We're gonna take a look at what's fundamental to the volley. So if you wanna learn how, or maybe you've neglected your net game in learning the volley, maybe you're just not happy with your current volley, then you're gonna really like this video. We're gonna go over some misunderstandings, I think, some fallacies, some things people have a little confused about ideal volley technique. And we're also going to give you a couple drills at the end that'll help you with your own volley. So let's do it. So first off, a volley is a ball taken out of the air, generally at the net. In today's video, we're going to go over your standard conventional volley. We're going to look at what's fundamental to a volley. Just a couple checkpoints and a couple principles that you should be trying to do. Again, for purposes of a fundamental volley, I'm gonna demonstrate hitting a deep, straight ball because to me that represents your standard volley, what you should be doing in that situation. And then we'll show how that relates to some other situations. Now, we're gonna show you some footage of some pro players volleying. I'm gonna show you some doubles players volleying, which I think is who we really should be looking at to volley. And then if I show you singles players, I'm gonna show you show them volleying in a manner which I think is fundamental and correct, because obviously on the internet you can find all kinds of things. But in this video, we're gonna show you what's important to me as far as volley technique. So the volley should be a very easy shot to learn. There's not much going on if you're doing it properly. We're gonna give you two principles and two checkpoints on the volley. First principle being, you want the shoulder to dominate the stroke. When we look at the best volleyers in the world, we really see most of the movement of the racket head happening from the shoulder. That's what's gonna give you the big hitting zone that you need to be safe and consistent on your volley. We don't want the wrist to work too much. The elbow doesn't really help you out either. You'll see why in the second principle. The second principle is that you want your swing path to generally be parallel with the ground. You never want to be swinging down too severely, and obviously not up too severely, but you want your racket path to go parallel with the ground. Yeah, sometimes you'll go slightly up. If you're right on top of the net, you might go slightly down, not as much as you'd think. But generally speaking, you don't want to be intercepting the ball coming from above the trajectory of the incoming ball or from below. When you play high level tennis, the ball's coming too fast for you to have to try to time that. So your goal is to always think of setting your racket right behind where the ball's coming in, especially on this deep, straight, higher fundamental volley we're talking about, and just send your racket straight on the path that the ball comes in at. Again, never coming from too much above or from too much below. Okay, now as far as checkpoints, the first checkpoint for the volley is the turn position. You don't want to prepare the racket with your body. Again, we talked about how the shoulder pulls across your body. Because of that, you need to turn and prepare the racket with the whole body as a unit. And you want to turn just until your strings point forward. In a second, I'll go over where this isn't always the case. But again, fundamentally, it's a good idea only to prepare till your strings point forward with your body. So notice how my body's turned. Also notice how my hands are very close together on the forehand side. And then on the backhand side, again, if you have a two-handed volley, that left hand's on the racket, strings pointed forward. Even if you have a one-handed volley, your left hand's up on the throat, you're turning just until the strings point forward. Okay, now again, the case where that's not true is if you did get a high floater, you could take a bigger swing, but notice that the swing's in the right way. Again, if it's from my shoulder, my racket is gonna stay perpendicular with the ground, so my racket's not really pivoting in space like this because the strings would never be that far open or not that close, so it's gonna be a lot less timing. So if you can learn to hit those floaters and take swing a little more in the right manner, you could take a bigger swing on your volley if you really want to crunch it, as long as it's in the right way. So when you're learning your fundamental volley, and again, I would say if you've been struggling with your volley, take a step back and pretend like you are learning it fundamentally. Your second checkpoint is that after you swing, you want your body to stay sideways. So it's not like a ground stroke where body segments uncoil. That's not how you generate power on your volley. The volley, you're just gonna get power from your forward momentum, you're gonna get a lot of power from the incoming ball, so you're not really gonna have to do much to generate force. So you don't need to uncoil your body. So it's really important that your body on the backhand volley for a right-hander stays over to this net post. For a right-hander forehand volley, your body's gonna stay to that net post. And just to help keep your body sideways, if you have a one-handed volley, you can separate the arms. That's gonna help you with counterbalance. It's also gonna help you keep your body sideways. If you wanna hit a two-handed volley, if you're more comfortable there, that's okay too, but make sure you keep your body turned after you hit. Strings are gonna finish up and out to the target. So just to go over a couple things on grips, definitely your backhand volley, whether two hands or one hand, you wanna be on a true continental grip. Now, forehand volley is pretty tough to hit with a continental grip, so you can hit or wait. If you're newer to tennis and you haven't been playing and you're not playing high level tennis, you can actually wait all the way on number three, an Eastern forehand grip if you want. But as you get to a higher level tennis, you're gonna wanna get closer to continental. Now, you don't ever really have to get all the way to continental while you wait or to hit a forehand volley, but it should be pretty close, almost to where it's a composite grip where you can get a quick change in for your backhand volley. The best volleyers in the world, anyone tells you they only volley with a continental grip, they've been telling you wrong. Even the best players in the world make a little adjustment, even if it's just with the bottom of their palm, to go from continental to just help get a little change in that racket face. Again, anatomically, very tough to get the racket face positioned with a true continental grip. So I want to go over two common problems I see on the volley that you really want to try to avoid. A lot of times we're allowed to do this, and it's also natural not to do it properly, but it's where people just kind of end up with a pushing, poking motion on the volley. And this helps you at first, it helps you make good contact, and then on the backhand it looks like this, where the elbow dominates the stroke. Notice how when you push, the elbow dominates. When you turn, the shoulder ends up dominating. The problem with the push is, again, you can only push so fast. You're always gonna be able to swing faster than you can push. And then also, it just encourages that racket face, again, to pivot like through space in this manner. So if you're a little early, it's in the net. If you're a little high, if you're a little late, it goes high. And then also just different heights. I mean, what happens when the volley's low? At what point are you just like this, pushing it up? The second common problem I see is what relates to, we'll just call the great misunderstanding on the volley. A lot of people think that fundamentally you should be hitting down and trying to slice down too much on the volley. This just isn't the case. Now, there are some pro players, some high-level players that don't get over to a continental grip on the backhand volley, and because of that weak wrist position, they can't really swing out as much, and they'll swing down and they will put a little backspin on. But again, fundamentally, the volley should be very flat. Your swing should just be going flat and forward. The misunderstanding comes when we do put backspin on a ball, what we're actually doing is we're removing pace from the ball. When you take pace off the volley, it makes it safer. You can pop it a little higher over the net, and then gravity can help it drop in the court before it goes long. Again, the volley, you're not imparting topspin to bring that ball down. So when you remove pace, you let the racket head die down. When the racket head dies down, it inadvertently does place a backspin on the ball, but that's from removing pace off the ball. It's not from a downward knifing swing on the backhand volley. Okay, let's do a couple drills to work on the volley. First drill is a shadow swing. You can do it with me right now. Go ahead, pick up your racket. Start in your ready position. If you have a one-handed volley, have your left hand on the throat. Two-handed volley, it's down here. You can wait from Eastern to composite Eastern Continental if you want, depending on your level. You can just stay on Eastern. Definitely do not volley on a semi-Western. Try to stay away from the bottom of number three and extreme Eastern as well. Okay, ready? Just do this. Turn to your strings, point forward, step, and just pretend like your racket's on top of a table and slide your racket down the top of the table and freeze when you're done and make sure you look like this. Hands close together, racket head up, racket's out that way. Do it five times. Program yourself to dominate from the shoulder. This. If you've been doing a lot of elbow wrist volleying and you start coming from the shoulder, you'll feel a little sore there the next day. All right, backhand volley. Remember, we're gonna get that little grip adjustment in for the turn. Arms relatively straight. I know where those strings are pointing. One-handed volley, we're just gonna step and separate. Again, every time practicing from the ready position, the little grip change, step and separate. Make sure your body's sideways. And just do that a few more times until you feel that shoulder get a little tired. There you go, two-handed volley. Same thing, you're just not gonna separate the hands. Pick up your racket and just practice it without a ball. That's gonna go a long way. So I apologize if we have a little background noise now. I know there's some stuff going on around me if you're picking up on that, but for the second drill, you just wanna find a wall somewhere and you just wanna volley against it. This is one of the best drills you can do for your volley. What you'll notice is if you're someone who has that severe chop down, it's really hard to get your racket ready for the next ball. You'll notice how the shoulder naturally lifts the racket face to where it's already ready for the next ball. That relates to playing tennis. You're gonna be ready again for that next volley really quick. Some on the backhand side. Woo! Feel that shoulder getting sore. Okay, so that's gonna kind of be our core volley fundamental video. From this, we can move on to mid-court and net tactics, so we could talk about how each zone of the court affects the next. Now you really wanna have a confident volley, to have a confident mid-court, to have a confident baseline game. Be sure to subscribe so you can get those videos. Also, the best way to support this channel is to interact. Please like, hopefully subscribe, leave a comment if you have any questions, and share to all those friends with crummy volleys.